Today we'll be taking a look at a set I never thought I'd ever add to my collection. Imperial Inspection. Let's get into it.
7264 Imperial Inspection has 367 pieces, 10 minifigures, Imperial Shuttle, which is just a recolor of the original one from 2001, so nothing too special there, and then two other side builds. Before we go any further, I do have the original box, so let's take a quick look at it. The box art shows the Imperial Shuttle flying in through the hangar with some lasers chasing it. Along with the minifigures, we have Emperor Palpatine, Vader, the guards, troopers, we have the little guy on his little cart, beep beep, and then we have the guy with a little crane. If we look at the top, it shows all the minifigures. That's a lot of minifigures. And then on the box, we see, what do we see? We have an alternate build, which is, looks like Darth Vader is piloting a mech suit built out of the parts from the Imperial Shuttle, which is really cool. We have, you know, it looks like they're eating dinner or something at lunch. We have flapping wings. The windscreen does come off. There is a little cart you put the Emperor and his guards on. Here we have the Emperor and his guards again. Up here we have, this is the TIE Fighter collection set, but it's missing one of the ships. We have a different TIE Fighter. We have the X-Wing and Millennium Falcon that were released. That's the around that time period. On the bottom of the box, oh, it's upside down. Not much here. We have the set number, Lego Star Wars, or, some other images, Lego.com, the barcode, 2005. Here's this side of the box. And then here's the other side of the box. Really cool to have the box in such a good condition. It's not, you know, perfect, but it's pretty good for it being 2005. For those wondering about the instructions, here they are. They're actually not that big. I feel like they should be bigger for the size of the set. Like nowadays, if Lego put out a set around that same part count, it'd be much bigger. But the first page just shows you assembling the minifigures. Then it's just like the sets. And if we go to the back of the book, you will see that it is done. There's some of the command station, little car. We go to the back, we see an advertisement, if I can get to it. We have an advertisement of the light up Darth Vader TIE Fighter set. It had a TIE Fighter pilot along with, and they pretty much threw in the light up Vader, which I do have. A great figure, highly recommend. And then we have a little thing you'd send in to Lego to get into the Lego Club magazine. And on the back, we have an advertisement for the Lego Star Wars video game. What's with Yoda's face?
And now it's time for the moment you've all been waiting for, the minifigures.
Here we have the Imperial Inspection Darth Vader. Now, one thing to note, this set does not come with a single lightsaber. I mean, you have those pieces over there, but there's no hilt. Why they didn't include a lightsaber for Vader, I have no idea. I understand that in this scene, he does not use his lightsaber, but still, it would have been cool. If we take off the mask, we do see he ain't got no eyebrows. This is when they removed his eyebrows, and he didn't get them anymore because the special editions removed them CGI-ly. So yeah, Darth Vader. Next up, we have the Imperial officers or commanders or captains or lieutenants. I don't know. We do get two of them, but they are exactly identical. For what reasons? I don't know. It would have been nice if they added a different face on the one or the other, but hey, it is what it is. We do have the, looks like we have three red dots and three blue dots. I don't know what that means in terms of the Star Wars stuff, but it means something. Let me know in the comments if you know what it means. He does not have any back printing, no alternate expression, of course. He uses the old cavalry hat. The printing on the torso, it's very simple, but it gets the job done, and I kind of like it. I like the feel to it. It's very complete saga-esque. Next up, we have the Royal Guard, or should I say guards. We always get two Royal Guards in a set. I don't think there's ever been a Lego set where we just get one. Let me know in the comments if there is a set where we just get one Royal Guards figure. But this is the exact same Royal Guard that we got in the original Imperial and Shuttle set. I don't believe the printing is updated and there is no back printing. Cool figure. They're still using this helmet today. So it just goes to show that this figure is somewhat timeless. And here we have the legendary Imperial Inspection exclusive stormtroopers with the leg printing. For some reason they have yellow heads, don't ask. This figure is amazing. The fact that they just, you know, only put them in one set is kind of just disappointing. I would have been really cool if they made this the standard for minifigures up until, I don't know, a few years later until they redid the helmet molds, but not the helmet molds, the helmet prints, and then eventually they did do the helmet molds. But in my opinion, this is at least like the second best stormtrooper. My favorite Stormtrooper is probably the Rogue One Stormtroopers, but this is a close second. And for the longest time, ever since I was a little kid, I've always wanted these figures, just how detailed the legs are. It makes such a huge difference in the overall aesthetic of the figure. Just, it really adds a lot to it. And you get four of them in the set, which is insane. They easily could have just added two or none, but they gave us four of them. Four of them. Four! Amazing. And here he is, the main man, Emperor Palpatine from Imperial Inspection. This figure is just, so nostalgic. And the biggest reason because of that is he's light blue-gray. And in the LEGO Star Wars Clue Saga video game, Emperor Palpatine was in light blue-gray. This is the original print for Emperor Palpatine. They just recolored it a little bit and put it on light blue-gray head. The torso, I also believe, is also exclusive to the set. I don't think they made this torso again. With that light blue gray, the old ones have just light gray lines, but Imperial Inspection Emperor Palpatine, such a cool figure, and I'm so happy to have it in my collection now. Thumbs up. Now that the figures are out of the way, we can talk about the actual set itself. In my opinion, what makes this set so great is really the figures. The fact that they just repurposed the 2001 Imperial shuttle is kind of lazy on their part. It would have been nice if they updated the design a little bit, maybe made the wing a little bit more sturdy. You can kind of see it separating right there. Don't get me wrong, it's a pretty good design, but the fact that they reused it only, I think, what, 4 years later, it's kind of lazy. And the side builds, you know, they do their part. We have a little crane with a crate that goes on this car. This little crate does open up, you put things inside, like that's what crates do. We do have some tools in the back. We have a little buzzsaw, a wrench, and that's pretty much it for this. The figure goes in there, has some handles, a little light, some smooth pieces on the bottom so it can easily glide across your table. This station, like I said, you know, you have the crane, a little crate, an antenna, some little safety rail, safety first, some lightsaber rods. I'm not sure what their purpose is. Maybe it's supposed to be lights. We have a screen, and then above this is a random turret. Why there's a turret in here, I don't know. Maybe in case there's like a rogue ship that flies in. That's probably why, to be honest. We turn around, we do see another chair along with some lights, a control panel that looks to be a trench, some grates there, and that's it, really it for the side builds. Let's take a little better look at this. The wings do fold down quite a bit, like that. That's nice. If we turn around the shuttle, we do have a little cannon on the back for self-defense. We have some the blue lines is supposed to be, I think, thrusters. This folds down. And then out, oh, this broke off. Out comes the Emperor's, I don't know what, parade float. It does show that the Emperor sits back here. You take the Royal Guards' their staffs or spears, you slide them in these snap bricks, and then they sit on the sides, and then it just slides in right there. There's nothing that really holds it in. There's no like clips or anything like that. It just kind of just sits in there. This folds back up, and then you have to take the Emperor to McDonald's. And yeah, that's pretty much it for the shuttle itself. Here's the interior of the cockpit. There's just a little control panel, some buttons. You can kind of see, I think you can actually see through the shuttle in the back there. We do have some I don't know, cannons, I guess. There is a printed piece up here of some, looks like some greebling. And then a little vent, and that's it for the shuttle and the side builds. Nothing too impressive. I mean, it does the job, but I still feel like it's really lazy of LEGO to just re-release essentially the exact same build for the Imperial shuttle. Like, I don't have the 2001 built right now. I do have the 2001 set. It's just not built right now. I wish I could compare it, but I'm fairly certain that it's just a recolor. There's like no new techniques or new details to it. Now, if you're looking to swoosh this around, grabbing it by the fin will just break it. Ideally, you want to grab around right here, and then that will, it is pretty swooshable. Never mind. Anyway, overall, I give this set an 8 out of 10 for the time of its release. Back in 2005, $50, 10 figures, some decent side builds, rehash Imperial shuttle. It's not that bad. Nowadays, if you're looking to add this to your collection, complete, used, you're probably going to be running around at least $200 to $300, around that ballpark. Sealed, it's probably going to be like $600, I think, I saw listening for. This is definitely, like, if you already have an Imperial shuttle, if you already have Stormtroopers, an Emperor Palpatine, this is not required. If you're me trying to collect older sets, then yeah, if you can get a good deal, you can find it for a good deal, absolutely. This is one of the more expensive Star Wars figures because of its exclusivity to the set. I'm not sure how regularly available this set was back in 2005. I'm not sure if it was an exclusive or not. If it was an exclusive to a certain retailer, please let me know in the comments. I'd greatly appreciate it. I'm really happy to add this to my collection. It's one I've always wanted since I was a little kid. Growing up, I had the Star Wars Visual Dictionary, and I remember seeing this set in the pictures, and I was like, oh, it's so cool. I mean, the Stormtroopers are just amazing, and the Palpatine looks like the one from Complete Saga, and I thought that was amazing as a kid. But let me know what your thoughts on the set are. I give this, I think, like I said, an 8 out of 10. It gets the job done. It's a cool set. Very iconic. Let me know what your thoughts on the set are, again, in the comments down below. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and have a nice day. Peace.